Professor Marcus, I want to take a few minutes of your time to talk about a presentation you may see quite often in your practice, and that's headaches. Patients complaining you may have had headaches as nursing school students, but also migraines. ATI explains that headaches can be acute, chronic, temporary, or even life-threatening. Headaches can be triggered by colds, allergies, stress, and tension. ATI also says there's two categories, primary and secondary. Primary have no identifiable cause. These are very ambiguous. Anyone that you know that has migraine, tension, headaches, or cluster headaches, how frustrated they can be. And many times with these patients, we really try to help them figure out any triggers that they have to these type of headaches. Secondary headaches have an organic cause. Unfortunately, it could be a brain tumor or an aneurysm. Many times it's exposure to environmental stimulus or alcohol, bright lights. Sometimes it's from fatigue, menstrual cycle, or even oral contraceptives. They also said foods containing triamine, monosodium glutamate, and nitrates can trigger these type of headaches. Usually these, the secondary, are unilateral, one side, behind one eye, behind the ear, oh, I have such a pain. They say that there's auras and non-aura headaches. And auras, we talked about them before, when you get a prodromal stage, it's the awareness, they have something irritable. They don't know, something numbness, tingling. Their mouth. Second stage of auras is when the headache also may cause drowsiness. And the third stage is when the headache sometimes creates a visual migraine, and then there's a recovery stage. So they put the aura headaches into a certain category. The non-aura headaches, those pains are unilateral, both sides, and can last up to 72 hours. Sometimes they have atypical headaches also that can last as long as 7 days. ATI wants you to know what to do in your nursing care. What do you do? You create a quiet environment for these patients. They're tired, they have an exhaustion that they cannot rest. Medication-wise, we give them non-steroid anti-inflammatories, remember, give that with food, anti-emetics, and many times they have nausea because the pain is so strong, ergotamine products, and caffeine also causes closure of the blood vessels, and this can help headaches. Beta blockers. Many times ATI asks about propranolol beta blocker and calcium channel blockers, and that you need to check the blood pressure. So this is a secondary beneficial effect from beta blockers to help patients with headaches. But on the other hand, you need to teach them to take their pulse and their blood pressure. Big question for ATI. Also many times they do Botox these days. They mention that as far as a remedy for headaches. Also review triggers such as caffeine, beer, alcohol, artificial sweeteners, we mentioned MSG. So they talk about biofeedback, they talk about homeopathic meds such as melatonin, glucosamine, and compassion to try to use. But mostly with these patients, you want to have empathy. Many times patients with migraines, they don't seem to be recognized as a serious presentation. You as a nurse can show them the empathy and help them with the science to try to figure out triggers. And if we can't figure out triggers, what they can do to help alleviate and go through the type of headache that they're receiving and going and the passageways and the different stages. I hope that was helpful. Thank you for your time.